I have a great Friday morning story to bring you, which is that Donald Trump lawyers are again in full-on panic mode as they face the consequences of all the lies they told for Donald Trump before, during, and after the last election. And specifically, we're talking about John Eastman and Sidney Powell, because now they are finally facing not only the prospect of disbarment, but also potentially being sued for $1 billion and more. And they are flailing about in a desperate attempt to block it. First comes John Eastman. He was the coup memo guy. He was the one that flew under the radar for a long time, but was exposed for writing that memo to Mike Pence and Donald Trump and many others, arguing that there was this mystical legal procedure they could use to decertify the election on January 6th, where Pence could bring in new electors from the swing states, and that would give Donald Trump enough votes, or he could hold out states and then there wouldn't be enough and then the House would decide, blah, blah, blah. The point is, it was all wrong and it was devastating to democracy, and lawyers in California now are gathering together to disbar him. It says here, now that the moment of immediate crisis has passed, the legal profession should dispassionately examine whether the attorneys involved should be disciplined for using their credentials to sell a stream of snake oil to the most powerful office in the world, wrapped in the guise of a lawyer's advice. The Tuesday letter recommending disbarment also included a timeline of Eastman's alleged unethical conduct, highlighting his conversations with Rudy Giuliani. The timeline also notes conversations Eastman and Giuliani had with state lawmakers, wherein the attorneys reportedly encouraged legislators to decertify the appointed electors and appoint new ones. And it basically says that whereas this guy flew under the radar at first, it turns out that along with Rudy Giuliani and other people, he was like the legal kingpin behind Donald Trump's assault on democracy. And now we also look at Sidney Powell, who is getting so desperate in her panic attack that she is filing a baseless countersuit against the company suing her for $1.3 billion. And the company is essentially laughing at her in their court documents. That's how desperate her panic attack is coming across as. It says here, many of Powell's allegations about how Dominion voting machines work are flat wrong, many are nonsensical, and nearly all misrepresent and confuse how the voting process works. They are also tangential at best to her counterclaim, primarily because not one of them identifies an act by Dominion allegedly relevant to her claim. It is hard to escape the notion that Powell filed her counterclaim simply to allow her to assert these absurd allegations, as well as make false and unfounded arguments of spoliation in the protected context of a court filing. If Powell's absurd allegations remain in the lawsuit, which they should not, Dominion will be debunking them all as the case progresses. And so what they're saying here is Sidney Powell is abusing the legal process. She is abusing the legal process to spread false information about Dominion. That what got her in trouble in the first place is that she went on Fox News and she went on OAN and she went on Newsmax and spread lies about these companies, which is what got her sued and Rudy Giuliani sued and all these other people sued. And now she's trying to, in the context of defending herself against those lawsuits, panicking and throwing in the allegations into a court document, which hypothetically, at least according to her, protects her from being sued, but she's abusing that good faith and she is getting called out for it. So again, one thing I've said all along is that the Trump lawmakers, Trump himself, the Trump family haven't nearly faced enough justice, but the Trump lawyers are the canaries in the coal mine. And whether it's Giuliani or in this case, Powell and Eastman, the billions of dollars of suits they're facing and the disbarments they're facing prove the panic is real. I can't wait to see them all go down in flames. Maybe they'll take Trump with them.